health care.
Everybody should have some basic security when it comes to their health care.
We are done.
The debate.
Obamacare is one of the greatest catastrophes, and the victims are innocent, hardworking Americans.
Can make you feel dizzy.
So, what's the answer? We've come to San Francisco, recently ranked America's healthiest city.
This week, we're looking at what our government's doing to keep us healthy, and we're looking at the places running towards healthier lifestyles. The impact all of this is having at the doctor's office. No waiting room here, no appointment needed. This is The Race.
Welcome into The Race. I'm Chris Stewart, and we are here in San Francisco as we are another week closer to the November midterm elections. And this week, we are taking a look at healthcare across America. You can see the Golden Gate Bridge right behind us here. And Wallet Hub this year named San Francisco the healthiest city in America. During this show, we're going to be taking a look at some of the places that have had real success when it comes to healthcare, but also the cities, the towns, places that need to improve their policies. Now, when we talk about the debate over healthcare, a big part of that is health insurance. PolitiFact findings, somewhere between 11 and 13% of American adults age 18 to 64, they were uninsured during the first quarter of 2018. Of those Americans who do have health insurance, the majority have it through their employer. Take a look at this graph. This graph shows you about 52% have health insurance through work, another 41% have Medicare, Medicaid, or the Children's Health Insurance Program. So that 7% that's left, well, that's where the Affordable Care Act, also known as Obamacare, falls. And yet, it is the reason for so much debate in Washington when we talk about healthcare. Corey Rangel talking to both Republicans and Democrats about where they fall when it comes to reform.
Healthcare is expected to be one of the top issues for voters in the midterms. Polls show Obamacare approval has gotten more popular among Americans, while opinions about Republican replacement plans are more negative. Democrats are using that as a centerpiece of their midterm election strategy.
On the other side of the aisle, they never had a plan. It was always just repeal Obamacare, and I think they were infatuated with the whole idea of just destroying something because it had Obama's name on it.
With rising health care costs, Republicans argue they made necessary changes to Obamacare.
Under Obamacare, every individual in the country was required to have health insurance or pay a tax. And Republicans repealed that tax because we think individuals should have a choice when it comes to their health care.
A growing number of Democrats now want to expand health care coverage even further by pushing for Medicare for All. Under the idea the government would eventually take over healthcare from private insurance companies and every American would be covered.
Under Medicare for All, the average American family will be much better off financially than under the current system because you will no longer be writing checks to private insurance companies.
Republicans say the idea of a single-payer health system is too expensive and bad for most Americans.
Everyone, no matter how much you like your plan, would have their plan taken away. Instead, you will be put into a government-run plan where you have no say in the cost or in the coverage. Obamacare meant fewer choices. Medicare for All means no choices, no competition.
For The Race, I'm Corey Rangel.
All right, let's take a deeper dive right now into single-payer health care. We heard a lot about it during the presidential race, and we're hearing candidates run on it again this midterm. Newsies Alex Miller and cartoonist Nick Raffurzo cutting through the myths and talking about how this system would really work.
58% of Americans support Medicare for All. So how does it work? Medicare for All, also known as single-payer health care, would break the link between employment and insurance. That would expand the existing safety net for people over 65 to include all Americans. And it would cover the whole spectrum of care for every citizen, from primary to vision to oral to mental health. Instead of paying a premium to a for-profit insurance company, Americans would pay a tax. Employers would do the same thing through a payroll tax. Right now, the average American pays about $5,000 a year in premiums. The tax would be about $1,100. The average employer contribution is now around $12,600. Their tax would be $3,350. This would represent a big savings from our current system. Opponents, however, say a government-run system leads to extended wait times for tests and procedures, which in turn can have a negative effect on our health.
And you're taking a look at Alcatraz here in San Francisco. And when the race continues from the Bay Area, considered one of the healthiest parts of America, the challenges even this area faces when it comes to helping people live a healthy life.